We know that a times e to the j of theta is the polar form of some complex number and can be represented in a complex plane as a vector with magnitude of a and phase of theta. Theta represents the phase angle, the angle of rotation in a complex plane. That complex number consists of real and imaginary parts. The real part is the projection of the magnitude in the real axis and is equal to the magnitude times cosine of theta. The imaginary part is the projection of the magnitude in the imaginary axis and is equal to the magnitude times sine of theta. So the real and imaginary parts are changing as a cosine and sine respectively as the phase difference change. If the magnitude is variable, for instance if a is a cosine function of time, then at each instant of time, we have a different magnitude value with the same phase angle, and hence a different real and imaginary parts. The front view is showing the vector in a complex plane. The top view is showing the projection of the magnitude variation on the real axis, the variation of the real component of the vector with respect to time. The side view is showing the projection of the magnitude variation on the imaginary axis, the variation of the imaginary component of the vector with respect to time. Now the magnitude is a function of time, and as the phase angle change, the whole function rotates in a complex plane. This formula can represent electrical signals, such as voltage and current. For instance, the voltage across the impedance has exactly the same form, as we will see in this video. In AC analysis, most of the time we're interested in the average value of the voltage and current, not in instantaneous. For instance, when we measure the current drawn by a motor, we're interested in the average value. We don't want to measure current at each instant of time. The average of a sinusoidal signal is called the RMS value and is equal to the peak amplitude divided by square root of 2. So if you replace the time-dependent amplitude with the average value, we get a complex number with constant amplitude that doesn't change with time and rotated some angle theta in a complex plane. The average is a complex number, a constant value that doesn't change with time and rotated some angle theta. It has a real part, the projection on the real axis, and an imaginary part, the projection on the imaginary axis, and represented with a vector with magnitude and phase in a complex plane, the front view. Impedance is a complex number with magnitude and phase. The magnitude of the impedance is constant. It can be represented in time domain as a constant value rotated theta degrees in a complex plane. If we have a sinusoidal current passing through it, then the voltage across the impedance is equal to the current times the impedance. At each point of time, the voltage is equal to the current times the impedance magnitude and rotated theta degrees. The voltage and current can also be represented by their average values, or RMS values. Here we have the instantaneous voltage and current, as well as their average values. So the impedance phase angle determines the angle between the voltage and current, instantaneous as well as average. Here the impedance is inductive, meaning the phase angle is positive, in the first quadrant, and hence the voltage leads the current by theta degrees. If the impedance is capacitive, when the phase angle is negative, in the fourth quadrant, the voltage would lag the current by theta degrees. The power consumed in the impedance is the voltage across the impedance times the current flowing through it, the current squared times the impedance. First, square the current, scale it by the impedance magnitude, and then rotate it theta degrees in the complex plane. This is called instantaneous complex power, a complex number with magnitude and phase, but the magnitude is changing as time goes on. Complex number with different magnitude at each point of time. When we use power meter to measure the power consumed in a load, we intended to measure the average power, not an instantaneous. We don't want to measure power at each point of time and get different value. In fact, power meters are sensitive only to the average power. To get the average value of the power, we replace the voltage and current by their RMS values. The impedance magnitude is the voltage RMS over the current RMS, and hence the average power consumed in the impedance is the voltage RMS times current RMS, which is a constant value and rotated by theta degrees in a complex plane. When we say complex power, we mean the average complex power, not instantaneous. As the phase angle change, instantaneous as well as average complex power rotate in a complex plane. Whether instantaneous or average, complex power has real and imaginary parts, the top view and the side view respectively. The real part is called active power, real power. The imaginary part is called reactive power. You can revisit my AC power analysis tutorial to get some intuition about the meaning of active and reactive power. Instantaneous complex power is the sum of instantaneous active and reactive power. The average complex power is the sum of average active and reactive power. Complex power is divided between active and reactive powers based on the phase angle, the angle of rotation. As the active power goes up, the reactive power goes down and vice versa. We're interested only in the average complex power. So from now on, we will use average values of the voltage, current, and power. So if the current is having some phase angle phi, or rotated phi degrees from the positive real axis, then the voltage should rotate an angle theta above the current. Theta is determined by the impedance. Recall that impedance phase angle determines the angle between the voltage and current. The power is the product of the voltage and current, and rotated an angle equal to the sum of two angles associated with the voltage and current. Since it is rotated in a complex plane, we call it complex power, a complex number with magnitude and phase. It also has real and imaginary parts. Instantaneous complex power is the product of instantaneous voltage and current. Average complex power is the product of average voltage and current. Now you have the whole picture in 3D. What you will see in textbooks is only the front view of the average complex power. A complex number, or a vector with magnitude equal to the product of the voltage and current RMS values, and rotated some angle theta. The magnitude is called apparent power. That vector has real and imaginary parts, representing active and reactive power respectively. The apparent power is equal to the active power when the phase angle is 0, and is equal to the reactive power when the phase angle is 90 degrees positive or negative. If we trace the variation of active and reactive power as we sweep the phase, we found out that the active power forms cosine function with respect to the phase angle, with magnitude equal to the apparent power, while reactive power forms a sine. If we trace the variation of the whole complex power with respect to the phase angle, we get the same result. The real part, or the active power, is a cosine function of the phase, while the imaginary part, or the reactive power, is a sine function of the phase. That's what expected. The real part of a complex number is equal to the magnitude times cosine the angle, and the imaginary part is the magnitude times sine. In my AC power analysis video, I explained that the active power is the only useful power dissipated in the load. Reactive power is just bouncing back and forth between the source and the load. Active power is the apparent power times cosine of the phase. Cosine of the phase is called power factor. A term determines how much the useful power is in a complex power. Power factor of 1 means the phase angle is 0, and the whole power is active. No reactive power exists. Power factor of 0 means the phase angle is 90 degrees, and the whole power is reactive. No active power exists. In electrical engineering, we tend to design systems with power factor as close to 1 as possible.